x sin theta cos theta. Okay, so this is number one. Now let's take the same problem and we'll do something else. Here's the same plate. This time I'm pulling this way. And then I want to find out what's the stress on that surface, n theta. Okay, now notice, you know, you remember the notation, right? So what will be this call, what will this be called? So let us call this distance L again from here to here. This time notice that the stress on this face will be called sigma yy. Face is perpendicular to y, direction of the force is y. This will be called sigma minus y, which happens to be equal to sigma yy by equilibrium conditions. Again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut just this triangle out. So this time I have triangle like this, and then the normal direction is that. The angle that it makes, this angle is theta, so this is 90 minus theta, and then the force is being applied this way. This is sigma yy is the stress, force is P2, this length is L, thickness is as usual T. Okay, and we want to find the stress on this face. As usual, equilibrium will tell us that the force, summation of forces in the y direction will tell you that F will be like this. And this time we are clever, we mark T direction like that. And this time around, well, this is supposed to be right angles. It looks horrible, but it's supposed to be right angles. Okay, so what happens is now, as usual, we'll find F equal to P2 in the y direction. And we are done as far as equilibrium goes. I mean, that's the easy part. I wanted to understand after that, this is all math. So done, then we start math. And the math says sigma nn equal to F cos, now it is 90 minus theta, divided by, remember this angle was 90 minus theta, divided by a L over cos 90 minus theta times T. So cos 90 minus theta is sine theta, so we'll get F sine squared theta divided by LT, which turns out to be sigma yy sine squared theta. If you compute tau xy, or sigma nt will be, this time notice this angle is theta, so remember I told you it will alternate like that, right? So it will give me F, which is P2 cos theta divided by L cos 90 minus theta, which is equal to sigma yy cos theta sin theta. Sorry, L over cos, that's the area. This time we get the other version, okay? Last time we got cos squared theta and sin theta minus sin theta cos theta. This time we got sin squared theta and plus sin theta cos theta. So it depends upon which way the angle is oriented. This is nothing but trigonometry, that's all. There is no physics. After writing F equal to P2 in the y direction, this rest of the stuff is just pure math. There's nothing to it other than doing some simple trigonometry and doing vector components. You know, we have been through this many, many times. So that's the, you know, you have to get used to this. Okay, our next case. This is a tricky one. I will show you what I mean. I have the same body. Okay, this time I am not applying normal forces. This time I am applying shear forces. And for equilibrium, if I apply shear force this way, I have to apply shear force that way on the other side, right? But notice, summation of moments not equal to zero. We don't really care because we are only going to look at forces. So that's a nice thing. You know, we don't really care at this point. We will later see what moments does to us. Right now, we don't care about the moments. We're just looking summation of forces. As usual, I'm going to draw a cut like this. Normal, theta, and then I'm going to take a slice like that. Okay. Now what happens? I'm going to draw it large, like that. So, F will be like this. There is the normal. So, this is called F1, by the way. And then, there is my tangent direction. And then, as usual, summation of forces in the y direction gives me 0, implies the force on this face. Let's pick our color. The force on this face will be that of this. Oh, I'm sorry. I should have. I apologize. Let me do this problem. Okay, so now we have looked at two cases, one in which I am applying forces along the x-axis, the next I am looking at forces along the y-axis. Now